The news: Uganda's first oil production date has been pushed to 2025 from 2022. This was announced by President Yoweri Museveni during the 59th Independence Day celebrations today at Kololo Independence Grounds. President Museveni also ordered government officials to cut their travels abroad after three of his close servants got infected with COVID-19 on trips to Dubai and Ethiopia. The colorful 59th Independence Day anniversary was celebrated under the theme, Securing Our Future Through National Mindset Change.
Today, the 9th of October, 2021, is the 59th Independence Day anniversary of Uganda.
In his Independence Day address at Kololo Independence Grounds today, President Yoweri Museveni announced the extension of the date for Uganda's first oil to 2025 from 2022. Museveni noted that all agreements, including the final investment decision, have been concluded to have the first oil production in 2025.
By end of June 2022, our GDP will be standing at US dollars about 41 billion by foreign exchange method, and at US dollars 117 billion by the PPP method, purchasing power parity method. All this without including the contributions of the first oil to be pumped out of the ground. First oil to be pumped out of the ground will be achieved by 2025 because all the agreements have been signed.
The president attributed the delays to corrupt government officials who are frustrating progress of government projects. This is the third time the government has changed the oil production dates, having failed on the 2020 target and now 2022. On Tuesday, the government tabled the East African Crude Oil Pipeline Bill 2021 in Parliament in a bid to fast-track oil production in the country.
All these achievements are in spite of the corruption of some public officials, including some political actors. I congratulate the whistleblowers who patriotically expose these criminals, parasites, and traitors to their own people. I therefore congratulate the people of Uganda, the people of Africa, our brothers and sisters, and our partners in the world.
At the same event, President Museveni ordered government officials to cut their travels abroad. He confessed that he survived COVID-19 narrowly on his trip to Dubai and Ethiopia this week. The president revealed that three of his close aides tested positive for COVID, including the presidential jet mechanic who sat close to him during the trip.
In my team, the president's team, we came back with three corona infections, two from Dubai and one from Ethiopia. So when we came back, they had to check us again. We are still all right, but we shall have to check again after a few days. And you can imagine, especially Dubai, they are very, very strict. They are not like other places. But still, these people picked up those cases there. So, please, avoid all these unnecessary troubles. Shimanyi chemunonya, iyo abana Uganda jibatero kwenjera.
Museveni explained how Uganda has grown to stand on its own to fight deadly calamities like locust invasion and the rising water levels. He urged Ugandans to embrace a money economy by tapping into government programs tailored to alleviate poverty.
As we go on, the difference between wealth creators and parasites would become clearer. The ranks of the wealth creators are going to be swelled by the Paris Development Model and by the Emyoga programs. These plans are aimed at converting the remaining 39% of the homesteads from the Okora Echida Chonka, Okora Rutoroka, subsistence farming to commercial farming and other money generating enterprises with Echibaro, Chura, Aymar, Otita, proper enterprise selection.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news at Kololo.